नमस्ते, यू आर वेलकम टू आवर वर्चुअल क्लास रन बाय एनपीएसएन कास्की। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर लर्निंग सोशल स्टडीज क्लास 7 यूनिट 2 लेसन 2। इट इज द टॉपिक ऑफ सोशल कस्टम। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू शुड नो व्हाट सोशल कस्टम इज। सोशल मीन्स ऑफ सोसाइटी, कंसर्न टू, रिलेटेड टू, कनेक्टेड टू सोसाइटी, सामाजिक। एंड द कस्टम मीन्स द प्रैक्टिस्ड बिलीफ, प्रैक्टिस बिहेवियर, traditional activities that we have been following. What we have been following is the social practice, social activity, social behavior. That is called hamro parampara, riti rivaj, custom, chal chalan, the practiced experienced activity. It is related to caste, religion, culture, geography that differ from place to place, caste to caste, religion to religion. It is a varied one, diverse one. Okay, now social customs means the activities performed in society. They are traditional one. They have the root establishment of the society, totally rooted in society, practiced in society. And social custom differ from place to place means one custom of one place that does not match to the another one. The activities or the dance, culture, and then rites and rituals, what we have been following, they do not match one to another because these are the general practices of the society. These are the experience of the society or the practiced belief of the society. Feasts and festivals, that is the social custom. Means Nepalese society, our society is heterogeneous. Nepal is multi-religious country, many religion, almost 10 religions have been followed by the people here. And then it is multi-ethnic, multi-racial, and geographically uneven. So we have various social customs. We are rich in it. Number of feasts and festivals are observed with pomp and joy. Means from Brahmin to Rai Limbu, or Tharu to Sherpa, or the Saint Thakuri of Humla Jumla, and then Muslim, Christian, Hindus, Buddhist, or Kirat, they observe the festivals according to their practice, according to their methodology or their scripture. They are varied one. They were celebrated with their pomp and joy, means with the total happiness, with total pleasure, with total merriment. These ties wholeheartedly unify the society. Feasts and festivals, what we observe, they are according to our race, according to our culture, according to our religion. And they bind us totally. And then they bring the people of such category together. And that develops the unity, social unity, harmony, and cooperation. So social custom is important because they develop the social harmony, social coexistence. So it is important. And Buddha Purnima, or that Bakrid Eid, or Dasain Tihar, these are the major feasts and festivals we have been following. Unique characteristics of our society. And then our society is multi-religious, multicultural, heterogeneous society, diverse society. And we have been following the politeness here. And then we are hospitable to our guests. We respect guests as our God. That is our unique characteristics. And that's not available any other places. Perform parma paincho harmonious cooperation means we practice aicho paincho arma parma. Means that if something lacks in us, we can get from other. Mutually cooperate each other. Then these are the common characteristics of Nepalese society. we are helpful, and then we want to live in the total coexistence. We have the belief that we should live together. Then another extends the help in social ceremonies like marriage, birth of bandha, etc. What are the social activities? Common social activities. And then we show our presence there, we take part there, and then we help the people. We give total what? Company to our relatives, to our nearest fellows. It is the characteristics of Nepalese society. And have the habit of loving, caring juniors and respecting the seniors. And then it is the general practice of the Nepalese society. We have the habit of respecting the seniors one, caring juniors one. And then we engage in the social feast and festivals with joy. And costumes now. Nepal is the country of various castes, various races. According to the caste, people wear different sort of clothes. And then these are resulted from the geography, the climate, and the capacity of people. And Nepal is the country having various sorts of climate. According to the climate, from the southern slope to the northern highland, we have seen different sorts of costumes, means posak. Okay, and then in southern part there is hot climate, and then people use the thin clothes, and it is suited to the climate. Okay. And then in northern part, Baku, Docha, Pangdin, and Tikia. In hilly region, Daura, Surbal, Boto, Soloforia. In Thorai region, Kurta, Pangan, Solbar, Sari, Blouse. These are the costumes people use. It means that it is our characteristics. And then Nepal is varied by the costumes as well. Nepal is multi-religious, multi-racial, and then having the character of land, multi what climatic regions we have, from 60 meter to 8848 meters, and then we people should live according to climate. We wear the dress which are suitable according to the climate. And you may see the picture here, and then these are the people wearing different costumes. And by the customs people wear, we are different. The Nepal is a country of diversity. And the ornaments means to decorate themselves and to beautify themselves, to make the charismatic view. And then people use the decors there, or the ornaments. And then by the ornaments we are varied one. People, according to their capacity, according to their region, according to the caste, they use different sorts of ornaments. Here is the example, rings and fully earrings, and then necklace, etc. These are the common the ornaments we use. And then in the ornaments we are varied, we are different. There is not uniformity. That is the unique acquaintance, that is the unique identity of Nepalese society. Now student, unity and tolerance, and it is the basic component, basic characteristics of Nepalese society. And we are varied in our custom, we are varied in our costumes, we are varied in our ornaments, but actually we are varied, diverged, and then we are separated by the religion, by the race, by the geography, by the climate, but wholeheartedly, by heart, we are united. And then we sit together but sing differently. We sit together and then wearing different sorts of ornaments and costumes, but we never hate one another. We respect one another, thinking that we are brother and sister, and then we have been wholeheartedly following the national brotherhood, and then there is the fraternity in our practice. It is in reality, means one Nepalese respects another Nepalese as well. And then without the background of their caste, creed, language, sex, and it does not matter to which caste he belongs to which their geographical region he or she lives, it does not matter. First, they are bound by, they are tied by the nationality string, rope of nationality, that is Nepali. We are first Nepali, then we are in different classes, in different religions and the castes. That is about our unity. And we tolerate each other, means one may say Eid Mubarak, another may say Merry Christmas or Shubha Kamana, Shubha Deepavali, Shubha Vijaya Dashami or Shubha Haritalika Tij, we may say. And then we exchange our greeting together, but there is not any sort of difficulty. We tolerate, one goes to mosque, another goes to temple. These are the common practice we have been following, but there is not the misunderstanding, there is not the misconception of the people. So it is the core feeling of Nepalese society, innermost feeling of Nepalese society. We have been inculcating or inhering it, and it is our characteristics. And we do not interfere with the religious and cultural activities. Means that wherever, whenever, wherever goes here and there, to the church or to the mosque or to anywhere else, nobody interferes one another, because we are tied by the Nepalese nationality, and we first are Nepalese, then we are connected to different caste and creeds. Then you may see the picture of the people relating to different castes and culture. They are living together, they are sitting happily, there is the total happiness and the total pleasure living together, sitting together, and then giving the pose to the picture. And aspects to be reformed means here custom is the what felt practice or the experience practiced, and then the dealt practice, that is the custom we have been following. We need to hand over it to our next generation, that is our custom. And but our customs should be reformed. There are something to be changed. It is not totally right. Our customs are to be changed. They should go along the need and demand of time and situation. They should be situational and the time mode, and then they should meet the need of the 21st century or modern century. And then extravagance means that while observing, while celebrating festivals, we should not spend much. According to our capacity, according to our capability, we should spend. We should not show off, and we should not show our showiness to others. It should not affect our later life, and it should be corrected. Superstitions means whatever our forefather is to do, that should not be followed by us blindly. They are to be reformed, they are to be corrected under the need, under the vision, under the reason of the time. Another one is the social events, like while observing the festivals, whilst observing the feasts and festivals, and then we often engage ourselves in the gambling, or the we engage the child there in the activities, they are wrong, and then they are to be corrected. Animal sacrifice, you have known, you have witnessed that animal sacrifice is in practice, basically in Dasain or the Eid or Bakrit festival. They are to be discouraged. Such custom should be corrected. We should not follow it. What are wrong? We should give up them. We should discard them. we should not follow them. And then what have the good impact in society, they are to be followed, they are to be practiced here. Okay? Now, today we learned about our custom. Custom is the practiced experience, social belief, social activities, social experiences. And then according to the caste, creed, language and the region, there are so many social activities or custom, and we have different sort of ornaments, we have different sorts of the customs according to our region, religion and race. We use different sorts of custom culture, so we are varied, but there is tolerance, there is unity, there is wholehearted national feeling, and then that have been tying us. It is about our custom. Students, here is the homework, and then you may list out the custom ornaments used in our society. Mention two festivals along with their any two unique features, and then you have been following different sorts of festivals there. What are the unique features of them? You can write under it. And this way I am terminating today's lesson. Lesson of custom, parampara chal chalan. I wish you understood it well. And then when you study your text thoroughly, you can uphold what I've been given there, and then my video may assist you. Okay? Thank you, students. Thank you. Have a good day.